Dolemite is my name, and rapping and tapping is my game. Yes, I'm young and free and just as bad as I wanna be.
I'm Krista Smith, host of The Corner Booth, and I am sitting here with Ruth Carter, the costume designer of Dolemite, as well as the screenwriters Larry Karaszewski and Scott Alexander. So I want to know how much fun it was to work on this project and also to collaborate, because the costumes are such a part of this story and this movie, and all the actors were talking about it. For Ruth, do you guys coordinate when you talk about what you're doing? Like, how does your process start?
When I came on the project, I really wanted to be impressive and do a deep dive into Rudy Ray Moore's filmography and all of his costumes that he had as Dolemite, and really get it right. And so I did a lot of sketches.
And a huge respect for her. But when we went to this first meeting and met you, and you pulled out those sketches, it was like, it was just so amazing that the homework she had done.
And they kept laughing at things and pointing at things, and then I was like, okay, you got it right.
And also, I gotta give her props in that it's so easy to do this time period as a joke. Mm-hmm. We've all seen that, those 70s things.
It gets sticky.
Mm-hmm. Oh, they're wearing platform shoes, mm-hmm. and they're doing this, and it becomes a comical thing. She managed to make the Rudy Ray Moore outrageous costumes, but they feel lived in, yes. They feel real, they feel like human beings wore them.
Yeah, and that was part of the goal, you know, to create a 70s that I remembered. And also, I didn't want the costumes to become like the joke. I wanted the actors to portray these characters and be funny and feel like they looked good, you know? And also was important, I feel, in honoring Rudy Ray Moore too, because he crafted his look, you know, so in so many details. It was important to do that, you know, do it right and not make it look like a version of.
And it's a unique situation because you're actually doing the making of the movie, so they have to have the same costumes that they had in the actual film.
Absolutely.
Yeah, I mean, so, I remember we had interesting conversations with you and with Craig about when Rudy's going for a meeting. Is he as Rudy, is he as Dolemite, or is he somewhere in between?
In between. And so we teeter-tot back and forth between Rudy Ray Moore sometimes and then as Dolemite.
Right. No, it's more like when he's going into an office to try to impress somebody, he gets in the Dolemite outfit.
Yes.
But he puts a costume on because he's selling something.
Yes. I mean, we were on the set the day they go to Dimension Pictures, and when we saw the group of them crossing that street and walking in that lobby, it's just people were like holding their mouth not to laugh.
Yeah, it was great.
It was
a great day
amazing.
For me too. You know, we worked so hard crafting each person individually in different sort of, you know, elements.
But to see all of them in presentation mode.
They come together. That was one of my favorite cinematic moments.
The only reason your ears made me look like I'm on a legitimate organization.
So you guys met in college, right at USC.
We were freshman roommates in our dorm at USC.
How did you get to this point of collaborating on Dolemite?
We joke that we make biopics for people who don't, you know, usually get a biopic. You know, we've done a number of them, and one particular one was called Ed Wood. And Eddie Murphy was a gigantic fan of Ed Wood. And we got a call one day saying Eddie would like to meet you. And this is like 12 years ago. And then Eddie just looked at us and was like, well, do you guys know who Rudy Ray Moore is? We're like, yes. We worship Rudy Ray Moore. When we were in college.
The trailer to Human Tornado, we would just watch over and over and over. So it's the best 3 minutes of all time.
What do you think is part of the success of your partnership? What works so well for you guys still to be friendly and still to be collaborating together at such a high level?
When we're writing about someone that who we really enjoy, the writing comes really easy, and then we have a lot of fun. And it's not to like blow smoke up Rudy's ass, but we really had fun writing this movie. And we just wanted to make it as good as possible.
And we love writing about characters who are extremely passionate about what they're doing. Mm-hmm. And that's certainly Rudy Ray Moore.
Yeah.
I found it so inspiring. I mean, I didn't know anything about Rudy Ray Moore. I didn't know about Dolemite. So I learned so much. It was really that evergreen, like the dream, the American dream about this guy against all odds, he refused to lose.
Right. Yeah, you know. That's
what
Eddie said.
No one gives him a break in the film. Right. No one ever says, okay, I'll help you out.
And what's interesting, because at the time, you know, Rudy Ray's movies were like almost below blaxploitation. I mean, there was, you know, they wasn't done by a major studio, and it wasn't even American International Pictures. So they were sort of the second rung.
Maybe not as mainstream.
Right.
Not as mainstream. Right.
Yeah, and you know, Dolemite was unique, definitely was unique. And so there's the 70s, which we dressed, and then there's Dolemite in the 70s. So, you know, we had to, you know, up the ante there a little.
I'm Rudy's protege. Yeah, I think I'm what they call in Hollywood an ingenue.
I also love what you guys did with the character of Lady Reed, and I want to talk about her costumes. It was added, it was a whole other layer, I felt,
well,
through wardrobe.
You know, Lady Reed had a certain persona about her. She was definitely powerful and in charge, and she had her look from head to toe, and it was as curated as Dolemite. So it was important that I give Our Lady Reed, Divine Joy, that same direction in terms of her having her look defined for her performances. And she was just like, you know, do what you do, Ruth.
What was the hardest part for you guys in writing the script to crack?
We lied to Netflix because we told them we were gonna do all of Rudy's movies. Mm-hmm. And then when we got into the writing, we fell in love with the records and the Chitlin circuit. And we started realizing, this is stuff we've never seen in any movie. And this is so cool, and this is a world that people don't know. We kept kind of pushing back the making of Dolemite. And at a certain point we realized, oh my God, we're not gonna get around to Dolemite until the second half of the movie. And so then we kind of, on the fly, had to kind of rethink what we were doing. And then, you know, basically everything we wanted to say about Rudy's filmmaking put into the Dolemite section.
So we don't know all that technical stuff like lights and sound and camera. You know, we don't know that.
Of course.
All right, hey, let me show you Dolemite Studio. Yeah, come
on. And also, I think one of the real hard things about writing the project was actually getting someone to make it. But when we met Eddie 12 years ago, and then we met with the real Rudy Ray Moore.
Oh, right.
He was alive then, and we interviewed him, and we talked about his life, and we told him we were gonna make a movie about him. And then we couldn't set it up because the regular studios weren't that interested in making a Rudy Ray Moore movie. And then finally we did the People versus O.J. Simpson. People were coming to us, and we sort of felt like we had an opportunity to sort of like go recapture like a dream project from the past. And through the producer John Davis, we recontacted Eddie
and
said,
Fox?
And John Fox, and said, well, Eddie, are you still interested in doing Rudy? And he's like, yes, yes. And so we brought it to Netflix, and it all happened pretty quickly after that. But it was a 12-year journey.
That's amazing, the life of projects. Yeah. It's like 12 years, and I'm so glad you guys stuck with it, actually.
You just have to just keep pushing the rocks up the hill.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Like crazy people.